Sorry I let you down.
It's not me you've let down.
No. You think it'd help if I went to see Mr. Sutton now?
You won't get that job.
I know, but if I just apologise...
Well, I suppose it could help.
Would you come with me?
No, I'm due in court.
Well, what about later on?
I'm going to be tied up all day. As a matter of fact, I must be off now. I'll see you later.
Mrs. Morris, on the second occasion that Smith visited Mrs. Brooks' home, the occasion when she was actually arrested there, did Mrs. Brooks advise you that Smith had returned?
No, but there wouldn't have been time...
Mrs. Morris, just answer the question, yes or no. Did Mrs. Brooks advise you that Smith had returned?
No.
No. She didn't advise the police either. Thank you, Mrs. Morris. No further questions.
Thank you, Mrs. Morris. You may step down.
Blast. Blast, blast. I may still get off. I've still got my own evidence to give.
Oh, yeah, they're going to listen to you, aren't they? Especially after the way our counsel has managed to get right up the judge's nose. It's not fair. You've tried to do the right thing by everyone. It looks like you're going to go down.
That looks like I'm going to get away with it. Well, you've worked very hard for it, B.
Yeah, well, it's not fair.
Hey, you out there. Come on, open up.
Yeah?
I want to speak to our counsel.
He's at lunch. All right. I'll see if I can find him.
B, what's the point of speaking to him?
I'm going to testify for you. I can't stand by and let you go back to jail.
B, I still think...
Well, you don't have to. So just leave it to me.
Well, Mrs. Smith, what can I do for you?
I want to change my plea to guilty. No mitigating circumstances, no nothing, just plain guilty.
What?
I knew what I was doing when I lobbed on Mum.
You mean you aren't? You weren't suffering from amnesia.
B,
yeah, that's about the size of it.
But Dr. Weiss was no fool. He diagnosed you definitely as an amnesiac.
Well, you better believe me. I forced Mum to harbour me, and I threatened to kill her if she went to the cops.
Is that true?
Yeah, well, of course it's true. Now, are you going to present my statement?
Well, we could ask for an adjournment. That'll give us time to get...
No. No adjournment, no angles. Just present my statement. Because if you don't, I will. Now, come on, get on with it.
Well, it's your neck.
So, I've narrowed the field down to 8.
Good. What time's the first one due?
Oh, about 5 minutes.
Look, Sam, when he comes, could you send him to my office? Hello, darling, what are you doing?
Courthouse is only a couple of blocks away. Thought we'd have lunch together. Court's adjourned till 2.
Darling, I'd love to, but I have to interview some lads about a job. Sorry. Oh, cheer up. I'll take you tomorrow, I promise.
No, it's not that. It's just that I'm having a bad day. Especially with Nick. Everything I do or say is wrong.
Well, you can't be right all the time, darling. Look, I haven't got any more time. I'll see you tonight, okay?
Bob?
What?
Would you consider Nick for the job?
No, Meg, I wouldn't.
Why not?
Because if I did, I'd soon have every kid on your books banging on my door for a job. Look, we've talked about this before.
Darling, we've talked about favours. Now, all I'm asking you to do is see him. Give him a chance.
Stephen Carroll, Mr. Morris.
No, hello, Stephen. Look, I'll be with you in a minute. Would you wait outside? And anyway, didn't we agree not to let our jobs mix?
Nick's in trouble. Haven't you any compassion?
I can see we're going to be here all day.
Well?
Okay. But I'm not giving him the job just on your say-so. He can front up and be interviewed like the rest. If he gets a job, it'll be on his own merits, okay?
Thank you. I hope you're not disappointed.
I hope I'm not either. See you later.
Mrs. Smith, would you kindly make your statement to the court?
I went to Mum's Mrs. Brooks' house. And I threatened her.
And why was that, Mrs. Smith?
Because I wanted her to help me with my escape.
Do you mean to tell the court that you were in full possession of your faculties? That you knew who you were? That you were not, in fact, suffering from amnesia?
Well, I did have amnesia after the crash. That's why I went wandering off. But by the time I got to town, it had worn off and I could remember where Mum lived.
This is most extraordinary. I cannot believe that a psychiatrist of Dr. Weissman's experience could have been duped so easily.
Well, it was having amnesia in the first place that gave me the idea. I thought that if I played along after I was caught, I couldn't be held responsible.
I see.
Which means Mum isn't responsible. I threatened her and she's
Thank
not...
you, Mrs. Smith. Mrs. Brooks can speak for herself. Well, Mrs. Brooks, is this true?
Yes, Your Honor.
Then why have you not mentioned it before?
Well, I was afraid. B. Smith has a reputation for violence. I was afraid that when she got out again, well, she would make sure I paid for contradicting her story about having amnesia.
I see. Mr. Waller, do you wish to question Brooks or Smith?
May it please, Your Honor, the prosecution would request a short recess.
The court will reconvene at 3 o'clock.
All stand.
When the hat's gang?
What?
A trial. Mum and B should be back by now.
Oh, give them a chance, honey. A trial like that could take days.
Yeah, it can't be too easy to prove you've lost your memory.
Oh, you still think she's having us on?
No. Once she stood by and watched that rat Margot bash me up, I knew B wasn't fooling. Speak of the devil.
Hello, love. We're just wondering what had happened to you. Where you been?
None of your business.
Get back to work, all of you. Well, that includes you too, Gaffney.
Hey, how's the trial going, Miss Bennett?
Oh, hasn't Gaffney told you yet?
And what did Bennett mean by that?
Went to court this morning. Told him the truth about B.
What truth?
That she hasn't lost her memory any more than I have.
You're a rotten liar. She's a very sick woman.
Bull.
I don't believe you. But if you are telling the truth, you're going to have a lot to answer for when B comes back.
Lagger.
Listen, kiddies. Old Fletch gave evidence too. Reckon what I said was just spite. Looks like the court believed him too, so it's no skin off B's nose.
You still lag.
So? She's still going on with her act. If she tries anything, it'll just prove she hasn't lost her memory. So she's not going to start heavy in me.
I wouldn't bet on it.
I won't have to worry for long anyway. I'll be off to Barnhurst soon.
They don't send people like you to Barnhurst, not on your Nelly.
Don't believe me if you don't want it. But I'm all set for the nice, cushy life in the country.
In the light of Mrs. Smith's statement, the prosecution has agreed to drop the charges against Mrs. Brooks. You may step down. Mrs. Smith, do you have anything to say in defense of your actions or anything to add to your statement?
No, Your Honor.
The evidence given in this court shows that you attempted, willfully and knowingly, to thwart the course of justice. The fact that you succeeded in duping an experienced psychiatrist bears out the view that you are a cunning and habitual liar. One prison officer was killed and one seriously injured while you were being escorted from Barnhurst to Wentworth. From the evidence given by the surviving officer, it would appear that you had nothing to do with the accident. And while it is not inconceivable that you suffered temporary amnesia, your statement here today leads me to agree wholeheartedly with the jury. I therefore sentence you to 18 months penal servitude for escaping from legal custody to be served concurrently with your present sentence.
Really much chance of B getting a mercy release?
According to Dr. Weissman, yes.
B said she thought it was a long shot, but worth a try.
Not worth the risk of you taking the blame too?
You're a very astute woman, Mrs. Morris.